Will you please raise the roof for Girls Aloud? Come on, let's hear it. Where are you going?
I don't know.
Go on, get yourselves up in the silk. Well, you can have... I mean, oh, yeah, you can get three on the couch. That's all right.
I could get round it.
Well, again, lady, how many times is this now on this show?
Lost count.
It's 10.
Yeah, lost count.
It's like every week, isn't it?
Every single.
You're coming every day for me, I don't mind. Shella, congratulations on Saturday on the X Factor. That poor girl.
She's unbelievable. Isn't
I thought she was going to spontaneously combust.
So did I. It was a build up of the whole day. Yeah. You know, them whole
surprised.
6 months have come to a head on that day. And you feel it, like you start getting calls from people saying, you know, oh, thank you for coming on the show. And you can feel that it's coming to an end. So we were like sobbing the whole day. I was exhausted by the time we got to the show.
What was she like after the show? Just in bed.
In shock, I think. Yeah. Mm. She still now can't really get her head around
well,
it.
Well, that's her life completely changed, hasn't it?
Yeah,
completely
and she's missing me moaning at her on the phone about song choices and stuff already.
Did you say so you can't have a boyfriend?
I said to her, no, a journalist said to me, are you going to take her on the pull? And I said, I am certainly not. She's going to concentrate on her music.
That's right. Now, no time for fellas. She's got to get the work done.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. And then when she's got the work done, she's got all the time
exactly.
in the world for fellas, hasn't she? Yeah.
Yeah.
But right now, get your head down, get the work done.
Yeah.
That's what my mother said to me when she boosted me out the front door and sent me off to London. Congratulations on the album, the reviews
Thank
it's out.
Thank you.
I mean, some of them said it's the best ever.
I know, they that's have
and it's amazing that that's our sixth album that we've done, and the fact that the songs and people are still really liking it and still finding it fresh and new. And it's great to be a part of something. Like
did you enjoy yourselves on Saturday, on your?
Oh, thoroughly enjoyed it.
Talk about Girls Aloud, world domination.
I
was in and out, wasn't I, with the dog, and that was it.
Still.
I had so many texts and people, and like kids, you know Girls Aloud. All of a sudden I had this power. So yes, I do. I know them well. Yeah. After all, in my house now, putting rollers in the back bedroom. Why did you call it Out of Control? Because I'd say, you five, you're not out of control. Well, maybe it on the ends.
Yeah.
She's trouble, that
what?
One.
What?
I've seen
you just
it.
Don't hear about them all. That's
Sarah, as I've crawled out of my skip in the morning, I thought, what's this? Lying underneath this roll of cardboard. And it's been Sarah clutching a kebab. Thank you on the base.
No, you know what it was, is we went into the record label and we were thrashing, like, names out for the album, weren't we? And we were arguing and they were arguing and one of the bosses just went, that's it, you're out of control. We
whatever
can't control
you,
whatever you want. And we were like,
that's
there
the
we
name.
Go.
No, because you're not divas, are you?
But, no.
We are in control of our careers and stuff, but a lot of things that kind of go on are a little bit out of control, so that it's kind of a bit of both.
And
really.
You can land out of control day anything too, because our tour is going to be called Out of Control, so you can kind of like do all different things and work on that theme. Like we had an album called Chemistry, and we done like test tubes and just makes it more
yeah,
fun.
Sure.
Are you going to trash hotel rooms?
Maybe
we should.
Do you mean? Are we gonna?
On the motorway services, go ahead and rip the radiator off the wall. Go in a little chef and do the all-day breakfast, scatter it around
there
the
we
room.
Go. It's too late to start being rock and roll now.
Get out of it.
Honestly, whenever we leave a dressing room or a hotel room, it's a tip.
Yeah. We're in there 5 minutes. It's like a hurricane. Everything's a mess.
We're like Tasmanian devils.
Who came close to death on the last tour? Who was that?
All of us.
All of us. Yeah.
What happened?
Oh, it was. Absolutely.
That
horrific.
Was close to death.
How close?
Such a dramatic story.
And me, you were sliding off.
No, what happened?
Sliding off what?
Right, we were lowered down at the beginning of the show in like a cage that was how many foot off the ground?
50.
50 foot off the ground.
Feet.
And so she's kicking off behind you.
So we were all kind of positioned on this cage and we're like, this is going to be fine. It'll just lower down slowly. So it started to lower and then one side just went,
Me and Nicola
were like hanging off the edge, honestly. It was
she had
terrifying.
Held my hands and where we were so frightened, you know, like you get sweaty palms. It was like a scene out of a movie, our hands were
they were slipping out like Nicola, hold on.
Think of the insurance.
They had harnesses on, mind you. So what use is that?
Nothing.
Do you know what? If you had seen the scenes at the end, it would have been like an Oscar winning nomination. It was there.
We had to get laughter off the cage.
Like, well, no more cages, just walk on with a bit of dry ice.
Yeah. Yeah. We like a bit of drama, so we have to think of something.
When's your next tour? When are you next on the road?
It's kicks off in May, so we actually start rehearsing for it in April.
You've got to have some time off, though.
Oh, we are.
Yeah.
You're off for Christmas.
Christmas, New Year's,
a couple of months.
We're going to take that time off.
And you're going to go home and do all the what?
Holidays,
pulling crackers and eating turkey and all that.
Yeah. Buying presents.
But the thing is, like, a lot of us don't see our families that much through the year, so we get really excited to go. Yeah, exactly.
But you are, though. I mean, you're really hard working. Every time I see you sat up there with that full of rollers eating a butty.
That's like a normal day.
I go home and then I come in again in the morning, and there they are again in the same room, head full of rollers eating a butty. All right, girls, still here. Now, look, there's been all sorts of nonsense in the press, right? Let's clear this up. Where are they? Hold on a minute. Nadine, do you own your own hotel?
No, I don't own a hotel. But I know, but that was a weird thing that came up. And then I kept getting people calling and wanting to invest. I was like, oh,
maybe
we can
talk about this.
Yeah. No, I don't own a hotel, but I do own a bar.
Oh,
in California.
My kind of gale. Yeah. Where's this?
It's in Sunset Beach in Orange County. Yeah, which is really nice. You can just kind of... When it's going to be opened, because everything's permits, so...
Oh, it hasn't opened yet?
Not opened until hopefully a couple of weeks' time.
Oh, you're going out for the opening?
Yes.
Do you want someone to come with
you? I go on Thursday. Hi, are you coming?
Howdy, fancy. I'll do the
you
bar.
You and Buster.
I'll do the bar for you. You'll be ready by 11 o'clock. Kimberly, are you going to settle down and have kids?
Well, I'm getting a little bit of peer pressure, actually, aren't I?
Yes. She's coming of a nice age.
She's coming over what?
Have a nice
She's
age.
Coming at the right age. Cheeky.
Well, I'm not married yet, so maybe we'll go one step at a time.
Yeah.
She ain't on to Justin all
if
the time.
You're
like, come
Justin.
On. He's going to kill you for that.
They won't. I'm going to be dead when you get home.
Isn't that going to be too scared?
He's under pressure now. Every time we see him, we're like,
just
are you doing it? Yeah, are you going to do
that's
it?
That's terrible.
Me and Addy will have a word with him.
Yeah. But no, I would love to have kids one day. I really am getting broody now.
Why didn't you get pregnant and force him to marry you?
Not quite at this stage yet, but maybe.
No.
Listen, girls, have a lovely Christmas, seriously.
Thank you.
And thanks for coming on again.
Thank you.
I adore you. Ladies and gentlemen, please, girls allowed, come on. Get out of the business. Right. I'm an all Irish then. Royce.
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 Here we go.
Before we carry on.